Around the world, there are 9.2 million people living with HIV who do not have access to life-saving treatment.
Professor Salim Abdul Karim, I'm the director of the Center for the AIDS Program of Research in South Africa, CAPRISA, and pro-vice chancellor at the University of KwaZulu-Natal, based here in Durban, South Africa. CAPRISA is an AIDS research unit based at the Nelson R. Mandela Medical School. It's been in existence for just over 20 years, and it undertakes research that has impacted the global response on HIV, both in terms of treatment and prevention. Globally, in 2016, General Secretary of the United Nations, Ban Ki-moon, called all the countries together in New York.
We are here to launch a countdown to zero.
To agree on a new political commitment for the year 2030. And the agreement is that we will end AIDS as a public health threat by the year 2030 as part of our sustainable development goals. If we look at our global progress since 2016 to now, we have actually done quite well globally. More people today are on treatment than they've ever been. We've had fewer infections now than we've had for the last two decades. And so overall, the world is doing better now than when we were in 2016. However, are we in a position to reach the 2030 goal? Probably in many countries, but not all. And one of the biggest challenges to achieving this goal is the high rates of HIV infections, new infections occurring in young women in Africa. That poses a huge threat. Treatment by itself is unlikely to bring down those new infections to the rates that we require to achieve the 2030 Sustainable Development Goal. So we've got to do better. And the better that we're talking about is to try and protect young women from getting HIV. And there we use something called PrEP, pre-exposure prophylaxis. The challenge with PrEP is that even though taking a daily tablet to prevent HIV is highly effective, it is not easy for certain groups to take a tablet every day, especially people who are healthy and don't have any illness. For them to take a tablet just to prevent an illness is a very difficult thing to do. And so what we find is that even though large numbers of people start taking these tablets, after a while they stop taking them. So we've been trying to find a new way to protect young women. And that way is to provide something that is long-acting, that you have to do just once or twice a year and not have to think about it more than that. And so that's where this new injectable PrEP formulation called lenacapavir comes into its own. It is a six-monthly injectable. You take a shot of this new drug once every 6 months. And for the next 6 months, you don't have to worry about HIV. No matter what exposure you may have to HIV, that you will be well protected. And the clinical trials that we were part of and many others were part of showed very high levels of protection. In the clinical trials, it was 100% protection. Now, and I've been doing medical research for 40-odd years. I've never seen anything that's 100% effective. So this is very unusual and very high efficacy of this drug. We have spent the last 35 years developing and researching ways to protect young women from getting HIV. We started off in 1990 showing the high rates in young women, And subsequently, we spent many years trying to find some way in which women can protect themselves against HIV. We finally succeeded in 2010 when we showed that tenofovir gel prevents HIV. But tenofovir, taken now as a daily tablet, is not enough. Lenacapavir provides a new alternative. But it will only be effective if we can get those at highest risk to actually receive and take this injection. So that means that we have to find some new ways, novel ways, in which to encourage young women to take this injection. We have to make sure that it's widely available. We have to make sure that it's well promoted. We have to make sure that the local clinics have stocks of it. And that means that it's got to be affordable, it's got to be something that's easy to administer, and it's got to be something that women are willing to take. To do all of that requires a whole new set of research, what we call implementation science. And then those studies must focus on answering the question, how do we maximally benefit from a new 6-monthly prevention injection? And to answer that is going to take us some challenge. But that question is only answerable if we are sure that this drug is going to be available, accessible, and affordable. To address this issue of accessibility and affordability, Gilead, the drug company that makes this drug, lenacapavir, have gained experience from one of their previous drugs called tenofovir. Tenofovir is one of the most widely used antiretrovirals in the world. And it's used in that way because they provide licenses to generic manufacturers in India, in China, and so on. And these generic manufacturers make tenofovir at very low cost, and they make them available in the poor countries, while Gilead focuses on selling its brand name drug in the wealthier countries. A similar strategy is being undertaken for lenacapavir. Gilead has provided the licenses to manufacturers, to several generic manufacturers. So we will expect that these generic companies will make lenacapavir available at pretty low cost. We don't know what that cost is, and we don't know whether it will be within the affordability range. As a benchmark, it needs to be below $1 a day. So that means that each injection can't cost more than $180. And we would anticipate that the price will be substantially lower than that. So let's say, it sells for $50 or $100. So that means that for, $100 to $200 a year, we can protect a young woman from getting HIV. And why is that important? Because when a young woman gets HIV, it compromises her future, it compromises her school education, it exposes her future babies that she's going to have to HIV. So every woman we can protect from HIV, at that kind of cost, it's well worth it. So now comes the question of when is it going to become available and when is it going to be licensed? Right now, we anticipate that the drug will become available sometime late next year. And when it is available, we hope it's available in all countries that require it to be at the lower affordable price. So, taking tenofovir tablets every day to prevent HIV is quite effective. It's not 100% effective, But it's quite effective in the range of around 90-odd%, 95%. The problem is women can sometimes forget to take the tablets. So when the tablets are taken, they are very effective, but you have to remember to take the tablets because even if you miss a few doses, it's a problem in that you now expose yourself at risk. So that's the issue. It's not that the tablets don't work, it's that it's hard to remember to take them every day. We've just celebrated World AIDS Day. And as we did so on the 1st of December, it was a good reminder that many of the challenges we face in the HIV pandemic are not merely medical, that they relate to the stigma and the discrimination that people with HIV still face to this day. We need to ensure that everything we do in our AIDS programs, in our AIDS prevention activities, in our AIDS treatment clinics, that we do all the things we can to reduce stigma and discrimination, to educate the public, to inform them that living with HIV is just like living with any other disease, and that if we don't address the human rights issues in dealing with HIV, that it'll be very difficult for us to reach the 2030 goals of ending AIDS as a public health threat.